seen our in our last class that our body is covered with skin, and under the skin there is bone and muscle, and under the bone organ and organ systems are present, and this organ or organ system is made up of cell. We have seen cell, organ and organ system. Now we will see this bone and muscle. That what are these bones? What is the job of this bone? Now imagine our human body. There is only organ. If there is no bone, then there is question mark. So can we stand without bone? No, we cannot. So to make stand our body, we need bone. So in our body, bones are present, and these bones are known as skeleton or skeleton system. These bones are known as skeleton or skeleton system. Now what is this skeleton or skeleton system, and what is the job of this skeleton? First of all, this skeleton system gives the shape to our body, it helps in the movement, and it protects the internal organ. These three are the main jobs. So what are the job of this? Job of skeleton system. First job, that it helps to move. If we need to move our hand, we need to pick something. So these are the bones which help us to pick something. They are holding and help us to pick. So second, it gives shape. It gives shape and support to our body. It gives shape and support to our body. And third job of this skeleton system, that this skeleton system covers the internal organ of the body. Or we can say it protects the internal organ. Protects the internal organs. Now in human body, the question is that how many bones are present? So in human body, total 206 bones are present. Total 206 bones are present. As soon as we are growing up, these bones are also growing up. But after a certain age, these bones are not growing more than that. You can see that after the age of 18 or 25, your height is not growing. Why it is not growing? Because that time our bones are not growing in size. But bone tissues are growing, because whenever we got any accident, so bones need to be repaired. So bone tissues are repairing it by making again and again new tissues. First note down, then we will see more things. A newly born baby is having more bones in compared to an adult. Why they are having more bones? Suppose there is one bone. In newly born baby, this leg bone is not present fully, totally, or means in one form, there will be joint. So as soon as this baby is growing up, this is a newly born baby bone. When this baby is growing up, these two bones are joined together and form one single bone. These form a single bone when it is growing up. As soon as again it is growing up, these bones are also growing up in size. And as its complete growth is done, then this bone stops growing. This bone stops growing. But what happened here? Tissues are growing. But bone tissues, bone tissues are growing. And for the growth of this bone tissue, these tissues need food and oxygen. For the growth, they need food as well as oxygen. Now what happened? We see one part of it in big image. Now this is the big portion of this image. Now when we are seeing on microscope level, so some blood vessels are running through our bone. Blood vessel means arteries and veins. Blood vessel means arteries and veins. These are running through our bone, means they are going inside our bone and giving blood to the bone. As well as with this blood vessel, nerve cell is also running through it. We have seen picture of nerve cell. This nerve cell is also running through it. Why this nerve cell is running through these bones? Because whenever there is hurt or damage to this bone, this nerve cell pick up a message from this bone and give that message to the mind that there is some damage to this bone and we need to repair this bone. So these two things are present in the bone. Note down. Now we will see one by one explanation of the bone present in our human body. First bone from the head we are starting. This head bone is present, then downside hand bone is present, and then back bone is present, breast bone is present, and then leg bone is present. So one by one we will see that how many bones are present in each of these. As you can see in this picture, this bone is known as skull bone, and this bone makes the shape of our face, gives shape to our face. And the possible thing in this bone is that it is the hardest bone of the body. These bones form a case for the brain. Here the brain is set up, and you can see this brain is having fixed joint. There is no gap in between. That's why they protect our brain. That's why there is no gap. And all except one of these bones. There are so many bones, and out of these only one is movable. Other are fixed. This lower jaw bone is movable. Only this can move. You can see in your face also, when you are moving something, try to move something, only lower jaw allows you to give movement. Other parts are not moving. And here two holes are present in this skull for your eyes. In this, eye sockets are fed up. The bones of the face are also having one hole for nose. And you can see there is no ear bone, and teeth are already fixed in this bone. And this is all about skull bone. And there are total 29 bones in this skull. The following picture shows the backbone, or it is also known as spine. In this backbone, many small bones are joined together. This single small bone is known as vertebra. This, when these bones are joined together and built up like a column, that's why it is also known as vertebral column. In this you can see there is a gap in this vertebra. Through this gap,
our nerves are running out. Many nerves are running out through this, that it is joining our head and then it forms our back and then it is joined to the last portion of the body. That is hip. It is joined to the hip. Now, these bones which are joined together, they are tiny bones. These tiny bones are joined together with the help of this cartilage. This cartilage means a liquid type thing which helps to move this one vertebra over second vertebra. Otherwise, there will be damage between two bones. So there is one liquid type thing is present. That liquid type thing which helps to move the bone over each other, that is known as cartilage. Now this picture shows the rib cage. Rib cage, as you can see, they are present over the chest, and these bones protect our lungs as well as our heart also. And these bones are flexible because when we breathe in, these are coming out, and when we breathe out, these are again come back to its original state. So these pair, the pairs of rib cage, in this, out of this, there are total 12 pairs. Out of these 12 pairs, two are not joined again back. Two are not forming cage. Ribs are not attached to the breastbone. This front bone is known as breastbone. Ten bones are attached to this breastbone, but these two are not attached to the breastbone. The following picture shows the bone of the arm. In this arm bone, there are two main bones you can see. This bone is known as upper arm bone, and this bone is known as bone of forearm. This upper arm bone is connected to shoulder bone, and this upper arm bone and forearm bone are connected at a point. This point is known as elbow. Where these two bones are connecting, this point is known as elbow. Again, this forearm bone is consisting two bones. You can see in the picture, it is very clear, there are two bones. Now this forearm bones is again joined with the wrist bone, and again this wrist bone is joined with the finger bones. And in our hand, we know that there are four finger and one thumb. In each finger there is three bone, and in one thumb there are two bone. In the fingers there are three bone, and in thumb there is two bone. And one more thing you can see in this picture, you will, if when you are going to count, so you will count 1, 2, 3, 4. But let me tell you that this portion is known as palm. This is not finger portion, this is palm portion. You have to count finger bones from here, 1, 2, 3, and this will be palm bones. Now you can see in the picture, this bone is our leg bone. There is also two main bones. This bone is known as thigh bone, and second bone is known as bone of leg. Now thigh bone and bone of legs are joined at a point. This point is known as knee. Now this thigh bone is joined to our hip bone, and as well as it is joined to the bone of leg. Now this bone of leg consists two bone. You can see in the picture, there are two bones. Now this leg bone is again connected or joined with the bone of ankle. And here again in our ankle. Now our foot, this is known as foot. In this foot, there is one toe and four fingers. This toe consists two bone, and other finger consists three bones. This thigh bone is the largest bone of the human body. And there are total 38 bone in this leg bone. Again, here these bones are joined together. There is one liquid. That liquid is known as cartilage. that liquid is known as cartilage. Cartilage means a liquid type thing which joined two bones together is joined with the help of this cartilage. It provide a very smooth area for the movement of bone so that there will not be any damage of bone.